All right, first round. It's like a pretty easy keep here. We'll probably be doing some aggressive cycling early. So let's see what we draw, but I'll probably get rid of this Wing Shepherd right now. We've just got two of our very expensive cards. And then maybe I'll play the Seeker. See what they have. Well, they got nothing. All right. Cycle this. Go ahead. Okay, and whenever you put one from another target creature. Okay, I see. Okay, I'm just going to play this Vizier. This effectively ramps us by one anyway, so I can start playing Quarry Haulers next turn. And my plan is just to slam Quarry Hauler into Quarry Hauler. I'm going to block here with this Seeker. I will gladly trade my Seeker for some amount of mana and a combat trick from my opponent, because I still want to be able to do Quarry Hauler so that they can start battling these. Sweet, this only removes one counter. That's funny. Should I do this monitor? No. We'll lead with the not foil Quarry Hauler. Add. So this looks pretty reasonable. Ooh. Cut to ribbons, huh? It's pretty good. Plus one, plus two, so it becomes a 4/4 if they've got one or fewer cards in their hand. Probably pretty reasonable to assume that that could happen here. Still, I think the play is just to play another Quarry Hauler. That gets a blocker out. They can trade. It also shrinks this guy down. All right. That's good news. They didn't. Oh. It's probably less good news. All right. Well, I'll just block here because I don't know what they're doing exactly, but they've got something. Maybe it's plus three, plus one, and trample. That would be a fine 2/1 for us. Not Magma Spray. Oh, geez. That's good for us, too. Just a little 2/1. I'm into that. All right, so what can I do now? I can play the cartouche on this thing. Draw me a card. Untap this, play wrappings on that. That's fine-ish. I'm at effectively 5 mana. I'm quite close to being able to just kind of do the things I want to do anyway. I think I'm just going to play the cartouche on this and then just see what happens. Okay. That means I can just cast the Shafet Monitor. I mean, we have our mana for whatever we need anyway. We're probably going to take a hit of 4 from this, being realistic. But then we can go monitor, maybe even into sandworm. I think that's better than playing wrappings on this, because I don't want this thing to be able to attack for free again. I want to be able to block it. That's interesting. So if they attack with this, they get another card and they go up to 3. That makes this very difficult to get back down. I'm assuming that they just have another combat trick of some sort. All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and draw it out. I could wait reasonably, but I think I can just cycle the sandworm here. Take 4. Sure. All right, we're in business. So we'll shrink this guy down. Pass. So we're taking 2-ish here, and then we can play the monitor. Oh no. Well, that's bad news. I don't think we can beat that. Yeah, I think that's just game. Because we have to chump block it, and we take 3 anyway, and then I don't think there's much we can do. Bummer. Fell a little too far behind there. Do we have anything we can do against the big dummy? We can essence scatter it. We could try to fit these in. These do seem very, very good against this opponent if we can ever cast them. And again, these do pretty good work too. Let's try it anyway. Feeling very ambitious. Okay. Mana's worse, but I think our game plan's a little better. This looks pretty good. Well, The thing's kind of annoying, but I don't think it's going to do a ton of damage. Maybe I'm wrong. Just going to cycle this lay claim. But I want to make sure there's nothing. I don't want to essence scatter first. Yep. You did it. Sure. Just pass. I think this is going to be good if we can get it on the battlefield. Well, we've got 2 7s here. I'm going to have to get rid of one of them. So I'll probably have to cast that out. There we go. All right, well, we're close to being able to cast this thing now. Question is if I should just get rid of this guy right now, or if I should maybe play the Quarry Hauler first. I could just cast this thing out and just be done with it. I could also cast Vizier, take a hit, and then untap with 6 mana, which doesn't really do much here, but it does put us one closer. I can also do that next turn. All right, I'm going to go for the Quarry Hauler, and I'm just going to attempt to block this. Just trade. And that kind of forces the issue, because if my opponent wants to trade or wants to use a combat trick, which they undoubtedly have, then it'll take them off of developing their board, which I think is pretty good for me. And they also probably think this is, you know, favorable just because it's a 3-drop into a 4. Okay, so I take 4 damage. Yep. Okay, I'm going to cast this thing, and then I'm just going to try to hit the Seraph next turn. And just assume that green-red is going to have a bear of a time getting through an indestructible 4-4. Defiant Greatmaw. If I draw something else that I can cast to cast out and something in the next turn, then I'll probably favor that. Are you just going to kill this guy? It's not unreasonable just to have a 4-5 and a 3-3. No. Well, 2-3 trample I think I'm okay with. This is going to be close, though. All right, so I can go wrappings. I can go wrappings plus cast out. That is hard to turn down. I'm going to do that. So what do I wrap up? This would kill it, right? I think it just kills it. I'll do that. All right, this is much better. I just get to cast out this thing. What nonsense have you got for us here? A cartouche of strength. Wow. Wow. What a beating. God, that's sick. Oh, I love that. That's just like the best feeling. Just brutally 2-for-1-ing your opponent. And And then playing a spell that I don't know if they have answers to at all. Maybe they do. I'm just going to make this thing vigilance too. Just keep slamming and untapping it. Ooh. Yeah, I'm just going to put it on this. It makes it a quicker clock. Okay, that looks good. Crunch for 5. Play this idiot. This just gives us 2 good blockers, basically. Can make a lot of mana now. These kind of combo, don't they? Don't have anywhere to spend it. Can't be blocked this turn. Okay, that's a thing. Nice. So I can attack with everything. I'm jamming. Actually, does attacking with this make any sense? No, I'll just attack with these two. This still puts them on a one turn clock next turn, theoretically, at least that they have to deal with all my stuff. Edifice. Whoa, I can do this twice? What a beating. More than a beating. Brick. And I think I just pass here, but like, the truth is that I can just untap and get another brick on it. There's haste creatures, and so I just want to make sure. Watchful Naga, sure. More bricks. Alright, so now they have enough blockers so that I'm not gonna actually kill them this turn, because this thing can prevent it from attacking, and then I can even prevent one from being able to block. That doesn't really get the job done for me though. So I'm just gonna attack with these two. And then they'll probably just trade here. I just don't want to lose to like the pump, the mass pump spell or something silly like that. But I should be able to lock down 2 creatures here, so I don't think I will lose to those. And I'm just going to untap here. I'm going to let them go to beginning of combat. This guy has reach. Doesn't seem super relevant. And then I just lock down this thing and kill him. Guess he could have the fog. Do I need to even think about that? Probably. There's no way they're running fog, right? But okay, another lethal threat. They're all lethal, though. Alright, so is there anything else we can do here? I could try to get cute and bring in like Spidery Grasp to combat some of the burn spells and some of the combat tricks that my opponent's playing, but I don't generally like that so much. Do I want Ancient Crab? Feels like the pump spells still just sort of get through Ancient Crab anyway, so it's probably not so great, and it's a little tough on our mana, so yeah, I'll skip it. Still, that game was close. That, like, we got to do our game plan and it worked, but, you know, there wasn't a lot of wiggle room there, so I'm still pretty scared of this matchup, to be honest. This deck is very scary that we're playing against. Alright, this looks like a keeper. We could definitely get ran over here, as we're not doing a whole lot in the first couple of turns of the game. But then we get to kind of explode. Like, we could just cast Shafet Monitor, turn 4, for example. Ooh. That's interesting. The 7 life does seem relevant. Okay, this is good news for us. Opponent has a slow start, too. Okay. This also could just get magma sprayed. But even then, I think if it does, we're not in the worst shape ever. Like, we can cast Quarry Hauler the next turn to block whatever our opponent puts out, and then maybe cycle and or play Shafet Monitor, and I don't know. What is this nonsense? Watchful Naga. All right. Annoying, but you know what? That thing doesn't hit that hard, so I'll take it. I mean, if you would have told me at the beginning of the game, you get to cast Weaver of Currents into a tapped out opponent and you're still at 20, I would have just taken that cold. So, no complaints. If this does happen, if we get to untap with Weaver, I think our plan is just to cast Shafet Monitor next turn and just be like, here's a 6-5, I'm going to start hitting you with it. Because that's a pretty nice win con. All right. Now I'm going to just see what my opponent plays, and then I'll decide if I want to cycle Shafet Monitor or to Quarry Hauler. That little idiot. I think I can just... I'm still actually just going to play the Quarry Hauler here. Like, yes, I have to take a turn off next turn, but I still have the option of cycling Shafet Monitor, but I've got enough lands in my hand that getting an additional one down isn't great. The card, of course, is nice, but what am I hoping to draw? I'm kind of hoping to draw a 6-5 for 6. So I think this, if I brick on my draw next turn, I'm just going to go Evolving Wilds, Shafet Monitor, Approach. That's going to be my game plan. I don't think it's foolproof, but I think it's decent. Wow, did nothing? Did nothing. Okay, I'm attacking then. This takes on some risk, but remember, it's going to be pretty tough for my opponent to race because of Approach, and of course they have no idea about it. Go. Like, even if they go tap some mana, kill this, like trial or whatever, they hit me for 3 or 4, I'm still okay, I think. And then I'm going to go bang, bang. I will block here, of course. Similar reasoning to last time. My opponent did nothing last turn. So you have to assume that for the five mana that they had, they couldn't cast anything relevant. So if I block here, they have to now use at least one mana, if not two or three, to get a combat trick to kill my Quarry Hauler. And then it makes sense that it would be hard for them to cast an additional spell this turn. So I'm taking no damage. That was pretty good for them, though, because they got to untap their guy and they get to draw another card next turn. But still, my life total is what I really care about, and it's looking just fine here. I get to hit pretty hard. The big boy. If my opponent attacks with Watchful Naga this time, I am less likely to block. Just because we hit so hard on the cracks. Combo? Oh, crap. Insult to injury. So damage can't be prevented here. This is... Okay, they're going to draw a card. So this is how this works. Injury does 2 damage to a creature and 2 damage to a player. So they can do 4 to this and 4 to me. Plus I take another 4, 5, 6 minimum. So I'm taking 10, so let's see here. So that's, yeah, it's 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to me, so I go to 6. And if I block with Shafet Monitor, it deals double. It deals double damage. So I can block here, and then it will kill the Watchful Naga. But then if they want, they can fire off and kill this. They're going to kill one of my guys either way. All right, well, I'm going to protect my life total still and also try to manage the board a bit here. And do this. Because this is not a trade. This is still, they still have to use injury on my Shafet Monitor. They were just, if I don't block, I take all that damage and they still just kill my Quarry Hauler and get to do the damage to me anyway. So I think it's better just to give up the Shafet Monitor, knowing that one of my creatures is going to die and still get rid of one of their creatures in the process. Now, obviously I can't play around this, but if they go like Magma Spray this plus injure this, then yeah, I mean, that's pretty annoying. But I know that this is coming, so that's the one I'm going to play around. All right, so we end up being at 10 rather than 6. And we're looking to be in a fine position. Ooh. Oh, I like this better, I think. I think I like this better. Attack for 9. And put them on a one-turner here. Just hope they don't have that one double spell that like is plus X, plus 0, and something else. I can't remember exactly what it does, but I think it's bad for me either way. Yeah, it's a sorcery, so they don't have it. All right, we got there and still had all these Approach of the Second Suns. Okay, next round coming up.